Well, hi everyone, Steve Patterson here again from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you the fastest way to turn photos to high contrast black and white using a gradient map in Photoshop. There are lots of ways to convert photos to black and white, but gradient maps are one of the best because they're so fast and easy to use, and they give us great results. I'll show you how to use a gradient map, and we'll compare the result to what we get by simply removing the color. And I'll show you the secret to why gradient maps give black and white photos such a high contrast look. I'm using Photoshop 2021, but any recent version will work. Thanks for joining me, and let's get started. You can follow along with any image. I'll use this one from Adobe Stock. Now, to really see how great of a job a gradient map can do with black and white photos, we'll compare it with Photoshop's Desaturate command, which is a quick way to remove the color from an image. Both gradient maps and the Desaturate command are fast and easy to use, so let's see which one is better at converting an image to black and white. We'll start with Desaturate. In the Layers panel, the image appears on the background layer. I'll make a copy of it by dragging it down onto the New Layer icon. Then I'll double-click on the copy's name, and I'll rename it Desaturated. I'll press Enter or Return on a Mac to accept it. Then to desaturate the image, I'll go up to the Image menu, down to Adjustments, and I'll choose Desaturate. And Photoshop instantly removes the color, leaving it in black and white. But the result is not that impressive. There are no dark shadows or bright highlights to give it that high contrast look we'd expect from a great black and white image. Instead, it just looks like what it is, an image with no color. So let's compare this to what we get using a gradient map. I'll turn the desaturated layer off by clicking its visibility icon. Now, before adding a gradient map, check in the toolbar to make sure your foreground and background colors are set to the defaults, with black for the foreground and white for the background. The reason is that by default, gradient maps use a gradient based on these colors. So if yours are set to something other than black and white, click the small reset icon above them, or press the letter D for defaults on your keyboard. Then back in the Layers panel, add a gradient map by clicking the New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon and choosing a gradient map adjustment layer from the list. The gradient map appears above the image, and this time we get a much higher contrast black and white version with darker shadows, brighter highlights, and better overall detail. If we look at the desaturated version again, and compare it to the gradient map, it's easy to see which one is better, even though they both took about the same amount of time. The higher contrast from the gradient map really helps the image pop, with more detail in his face and in his hair, and more obvious texture in his sweater and in the background. So why are gradient maps so good at creating high contrast black and white images? Well, there's really two reasons. And the first is because of how gradient maps work. A gradient map takes the photo's original colors and replaces them with the colors from a gradient. And the Properties panel shows us the gradient that the gradient map is using. By default, it's based on our foreground and background colors, which is why we reset them to black and white. Gradient maps replace colors based on their brightness. So because we're using a black to white gradient, the darkest colors in the image are being replaced with black or dark gray. The brightest colors are now white or light gray, and the colors with their brightness somewhere in the middle are now a shade of gray from the midtones in the gradient. And that's why the image has turned to black and white. But why does the black and white version have such high contrast? And why is it higher not only than the desaturated version, but also the original image? Well, the reason is because of an option found in the gradient editor. To open the gradient editor, click on the gradient in the Properties panel. And here, you'll find an option called Smoothness. By default, smoothness is set to 100%. And that means that Photoshop is trying to smooth out the transitions between the different colors, or in this case, the different shades of gray in the gradient. But this smoothing effect also increases the contrast in the gradient. It's enhancing the difference between the dark and light tones by pushing darker tones more towards black and lighter tones closer to white. And this is what's giving us that higher contrast with our black and white image. Watch what happens to the image if we lower the smoothness down to 0%. Suddenly, we lose the higher contrast, and the gradient map version now looks more like the desaturated version. But when I increase the smoothness back to 100%, the higher contrast returns. If you pay attention to the gradient preview bar, you can see what's happening to the gradient. Notice how far the darkest shades on the left and the brightest shades on the right are extending inward towards the midtones when smoothness is set to 100%. But as you lower the smoothness, those darkest and lightest shades get pushed closer to the edges, which brightens up the midtones. And if we increase the smoothness again, we expand those darkest and lightest shades back outward. The easiest place to see it is here in the darker shades. As I lower the smoothness, you can see those darker shades getting lighter. And at 0%, we get a more natural transition between black and white. I'll leave it at 0% for the moment, and I'll click OK to close the gradient editor. And now that we've taken away the gradient map's advantage, the two versions look more similar, although the gradient map still looks a bit better. Of course, the whole point of using a gradient map is to get that high contrast effect. So I'll reopen the gradient editor, and I'll set the smoothness back to 100%. So I really just wanted to show you there why gradient maps produce such high contrast black and white images. But to use a gradient map, just make sure your foreground and background colors are set to the defaults and press the letter D on your keyboard if they're not. Then in the Layers panel, click the New Fill or Adjustment Layer icon, choose Gradient Map, and you're done. And there we have it. That's how easy it is to turn photos to high contrast black and white using a gradient map in Photoshop. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos. You can also visit my website, photoshopessentials.com, where you'll find hundreds of Photoshop tutorials. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.